In this video, we are going to trade random entries. You might find random entries very strange, but I promise that you might find the results very interesting. So let's find out how to do that with MQL5. To get started, please click on the little icon here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the Meta Editor window, and here you want to click on File, New File, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file Simple Random Entry EA, click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Now you can delete everything above the onTick function and the two command lines here. We start with an include function to include the file trade.mqh. This one comes with simplified trading functions. Now we create an instance of ctrade that will be called trade. And in the next step, we will create an input variable that will be an integer variable called masTest. And the first initial value is 1. That one will become interesting in the next video when we talk about mass testing. Inside of the onTick function, we want to calculate the ask price. That is done by using symbol info double. For the current symbol on the chart, we use symbol underscore ask, all in capital letters, to calculate the ask price. And with normalized double and underscore digits, we are going to automatically calculate the right number of digits behind the dot. That depends on the currency pair we use, because some currency pairs have 3 digits behind the dot while others have 5 digits behind the dot. Let's repeat that process. This time we want to calculate the bid price. Everything is the same, except of this parameter. This time we are using symbol underscore bid, all in capital letters. And for the signal, we create a string variable that is called signal. So far we have no value, because that's what we are going to calculate now. Our random generator needs an initial value, and we use getTickCount to do that. GetTickCount returns the number of milliseconds that have passed since the system was started. MathSrand sets the starting point for the pseudo-random integers. So let's actually calculate a random number by using MathRand. And this expression here will create either a 0 or a 1. And when the random number equals 0, we want to set our signal to buy. Otherwise, if the random number equals 1, our signal should have the value sell, because now we want to sell. So if the signal equals sell and positions total is below 1, that would mean we have a sell signal and no open positions. And now we use trade.sell to sell 10 micro lot. Otherwise, if the signal equals buy and we have no open positions, we use trade.buy and buy 10 micro lot. Finally, we want to create a chart output that is done by using the command function. And it will output the text, the signal is now followed by the current signal. That's about it. If you have no clue what all the code here does, or if you think that this was too fast for you, maybe you want to watch one of the other videos from this basic video series first. Or maybe even the premium course that you can buy on our website might be interesting for you. For now, please click on the compile button. You shouldn't get any errors here, and if this is the case, you can click on the little button here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. In MetaTrader, we pick an empty chart, right-click, select Templates, Save Template, and save it as tester.tpl, because this is what we are going to see in the backtest. Now you want to click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. We want to do a single test. Please pick the new file simple-random-entry-ea.ex5, mark the visual mode here, and start a test. Here is our little expert advisor. It is running and it constantly produces buy and sell signals. So let's set that one to full speed. Here we have some results. So let's stop that for now. Repeat the test. Start it again. And this time we have different results. Let's do another one. I don't use the visual mode here to save some time. And this time we should see the third result. All results are different. That's because of the random entry. And in the next video we are going to do mass testing. But for now, you know that random entries do work. Our expert advisor is able to trade buy and sell trades that have been created by a random generator. And you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.